Hey, you geometry people. What we have here is a 45-45-90 triangle. A 45-45-90 triangle. Name that because the angles are 45, 45, and 90. This is an isosceles triangle that we easily create by taking a square and through the center of the middle of the square, we draw in a diagonal. And that diagonal is the hypotenuse of this triangle here. But this is isosceles. These two sides are the same. These are your legs that are the same, and this is your hypotenuse. And there's a pattern to these three sides that I'd like for you to learn. If we know that the leg is one unit, then we know that the other leg is one unit. And using our Pythagorean theorem, we can find C, because C squared would be the two legs squared added together. So C squared will be 1 squared, and 1 squared will be 2. So C is the square root of 2. So if the legs are 1 apiece, then the hypotenuse is the square root of 2. And that is the pattern. For every unit this is the same, and this will be that unit times a radical 2. Okay? So if this is 3, this is 3, this is 3, radical 2. Okay, the legs are the same, and we obtain the length of the hypotenuse by multiplying it by radical 3. So the hypotenuse is equal to a leg times the square root of radical 2. So if the legs were 10, then the hypotenuse would be 10 radical 2. If the legs were 8, 81, then the hypotenuse would be 81 radical 2. So if we want to find the length of the hypotenuse, we multiply to the length of a leg, the square root of 2. If the legs were, say, like 10 radical 6 apiece, then the hypotenuse would be 10 radical 6 times a radical 2. And then you just have a little math there to do. 10 radical 6 with a radical 2 would become 10 radical 12. And a 10 radical 12, so what do we know about a 12? A 12 is a 4 with a 3. So we could take out the 2 from the 4 so that we would have 20 radical 3. Whenever you go from the leg to the hypotenuse, whether it's friendly or not so friendly, you multiply by radical 2. If you want to go from the hypotenuse to the leg, then you divide by radical 2. So if this was something friendly like 10 radical 2, then we would divide the 10 radical 2 by the radical 2, and we would get 10. The legs equal the hypotenuse divided by a radical 2. Now, if the radical 2 is already there, there is no flicking. We're not flicking snot. We're dividing. So don't say we just cancel out the, well, we are canceling out the radical 2, but don't say we're just removing it. We're dividing it away. And if you'll remember that, that when you have things that aren't so friendly, like a 10 here, and we want to find the length of these legs, then you will take that 10 and you will divide it by radical 2, which is another math procedure that you'll need to keep up with. We'll multiply top and bottom by the square root of 2. We'll get 10 radical 2 on top. Radical 2 and radical 2 on the bottom. Of course, that's radical 4, but we'd put down a 2 instead. And we would reduce here if we could, and we can. So we get 5 radical 2. Okay? No way that this side and these two sides will ever be nice, all of them be nice numbers. You might have a couple of them nice, one bad, nice, two bad, but they're not all going to be nice whole numbers. Okay? One more. So if we know the leg here, the leg is the most important side to a 45-45-90 triangle. If it is 100, then the other leg is also 100. And the hypotenuse is 100 radical 2. If we know the hypotenuse is 100, then we get the leg by dividing the radical 2. Now, since we don't have the radical 2 to cancel, we must show that division. So 100 divided by radical 2, we do our little procedure. This gives us 100 radical 2 over a 2. We cancel here, reduce here if at all possible. If not possible, then we'd stop right there. But we can go on, so we get 50 radical 2. All right, take care. Hug you folks. Clean your room. Go geometry.